Hiya, I'm Professor Peter Kille and I'm head of the Technology Hubs in the School of Biosciences, and it's been my pleasure to help and assist the development of the COVID testing facility within the School of Biosciences. What I'm going to do is take you through a virtual tour of our facilities. We're standing here within the vestibule area where people can wash their hands and put on the appropriate PPE before we go into our testing laboratories. To our right here, we have our clean laboratory where all our reagents are prepared. It's of course, no biology goes into there. It's all for the preparation of very clean reagents. And we can turn just to the left and see our main processing lab. I'll take you in there in a minute and show you the various processing stations. So we'll go in now. We'll first go into the preparation laboratory. So this area of the laboratory is used to prepare all the reagents we use. Everything has to be aliquoted at clean and verified before we can take it into the main laboratories. So this is done both within a clean hood, as well as having all of our calibrated equipment that is of course up to the appropriate standards that we need for preparation of a clinical diagnostic test. So we're gonna walk out now. And we're going to walk out into an area which is a common area with all our reagents. We have all the stock we require, and actually this fridge is where our process starts. So of an evening, our samples come in from our collection centres and are placed within the fridge, ready for processing. And then once they're taken out of there, they're taken into our processing laboratory. Now, our processing laboratory, our samples are all basically supplied within these boxes. And the first thing we do is we take these boxes, sterilize the outside, and we introduce into these boxes our quality controls. So all of our boxes have both positive and negative quality controls mixed up randomly with the patient samples. And that's done so we can track those positive and negative through our whole process to make sure there's no mixing of our samples. Once they're brought in, they're taken to this station and placed on a special scanner, because actually the bottom of all of our tubes have a 2D barcode, and that allows our computer to read the whole box and where all the samples are in the box. And they basically cross-reference the samples with where they came from as far as the patient collection information in our LIM system. Once they're scanned in, they're placed in these ovens, which are kept at 65 degrees centigrade, which kills the virus. So at this point, the samples have not been opened by anyone, so none of our staff have been exposed to them, and they're placed in here to kill them. And that process is recorded, so we know that every sample has been killed before it's further processed. Once it's taken out of here, it's re-logged to make sure we know it's being processed and taken into our main preparation area. These large robots in big HEPA-filtered environments are used to transfer the samples from our tubes to a 96-well plate, a deep well plate for processing. And that is done totally robotically. So we have a machine at the back there that actually removes the caps from the tubes and allows the robot to take the samples from these tubes and into a 96-well plate. That means that our operators are totally protected from the virus whilst the process is going on. So basically, this big hood and everything protects our staff from any risk of the virus. And again, the samples are all capped and put away without any exposure of the sample to the operator. Once in that 96-well plate, the sample is in a very high denaturing solution, something called guanidine thiocyanate. That totally kills the virus. So it's been killed by heating and it's been killed chemically before it's processed. Then basically the sample's taken to these machines. These are our RNA preparation robots, and you can see Emma here just finishing some samples off. So we've got these, they're all touch screens, so the screens can be wiped down. We don't have any chance of contamination. The robots allow us to prepare using magnetic beads Each robot can do about 100 samples in about an hour and a half, and that means we can process our 2,500 a day that my colleague was telling you about. So, as I said, each robot is automated, but it does require the operator to sit there and check that the automation works. When it comes off these robots, we've got purified nucleic acid representing our patient samples. And from there, we have to go and assay our, create a qPCR assay for our COVID loci. And that's done just next door. Obviously, we wouldn't want to prepare our assay in the same lab as we're purifying our sample. So we go into another laboratory here. And here is our qPCR setup station. So again, another one of these little robots that are really efficient at making up the assay. So we usually take 200 samples and we run a quadruplex, so four different COVID loci, to confirm if we have a positive sample. So that each person is having four different areas of the COVID genome assayed to confirm whether they have the virus or don't have the virus. So this machine sets up our multiplex, and that means we can assay, as I said, 200 samples at the same time. However, the reaction that does that assay amplifies the COVID loci about a billionfold. And we would not want that amplification to occur within this laboratory complex. So we're just going to step upstairs and go to the room where the actual magic, the actual assay is performed. Hi, welcome to our area where we do the COVID assays. So here we have three platforms. So we can do up to, if you remember, one plate of assays, we'll do 200 different assays at the same time. So here we can actually do 600 assays in parallel. Now you're wondering what an assay requires. Well, as I said, in each assay, we're going to identify whether four areas of the COVID genome are present. So what we do is we amplify up those four different areas, and we have sets of primers to do that amplification with a specific probe. So that's a specific fluorescent probe that tells us whether that particular area of the virus is present. By using four areas independently, we have a highly accurate assay, so that all of the noise or false positive rate is incredibly low, because we're requiring those four locations to be present in all of our assays. We managed to use this technology not just to do patient analysis, but we're also helping the Welsh government do wastewater analysis. So by looking at population level assays, so by basically measuring the amount of COVID level within the wastewater of the Cardiff area, we are able to tell the Welsh Assembly how much, what the prevalence of the virus is within the whole community. And we're doing that both within South Wales and in collaboration with Bangor in North Wales. So our assay allows us to give us whether a patient has got COVID or not, but also quantitatively to measure the amount of COVID within a community. But yes, this is the end of the pipeline. What I would say is, this is an amplification. So this area is in a different air handling system and has a different waste route. So nothing that comes up here to our analysis suite goes back down into our processing suite. And that means that we can ensure that our assays are kept clean now and for the future. So here we see some samples which both show our patient positives as well as our internal positive controls. So on each sample sheet, we have known positives which we check and make sure they're quality assessed. So we make sure our complete process has worked. Once we have this, we can check all four loci are correct, and that is actually done both by an algorithm, but then human checked. And that's checked by myself and the laboratory manager before we upload that data to our system, our LIM system, and communicate the data to the patients. Now, actually in the laboratory, we're really conscious of personal information. And in fact, our laboratory contains no information about the patient. Our results are uploaded into what we call the secure data cube that the university has. And that data cube is what communicates with the student their results. That means there can never be a breach from the laboratory to the public about someone's results. So we're really conscious of keeping the data associated with the individual really secure.